Hi everybody, if you don't know me, my name is Lindsay. I'm a sophomore in CCF. So basically since the beginning of the semester, God's put this on my heart to share about international outreach. And when he told me that, I was like, oh, because speaking in front of people is something that's hard for me, but it kind of gave me joy too because I've definitely seen him working, definitely over the past year, and just because I think of how small our group started, reaching out to international students, and then we've grown, which has been like an answer to prayer. So I asked him what he wanted me to share, and he told me ICOM, which is what I think of as the start of many things for me, which it's coming up in November, and basically it's called the International Conference on Missions, and that was kind of the catalyst in my life. That reawakened desire that had been there a long time that I never really listened to, and that was to reach out. So after that, I started getting involved with international students, and it's been life-changing. And what God has really taught me is you don't have to know all of what you're doing, because so often I feel like we're scared that we don't have the answers, or even just talking to people and forming those relationships for like, and because we share this fear of not knowing and going into those waters, we don't reach out. And if God has taught me anything, it's that he delights in using the weak. He delights in us telling him, you know what? I have no idea what I'm doing, and that's okay. And it's okay to be afraid, but it's not okay to let that fear stop us. So I encourage you that if you feel that tugging in your heart, even if you feel like you're not the right person, if God tells you that, then you are. And just because he calls other people, or you think that they might be doing a better job than you, that doesn't mean you needed less. It means, if anything, you needed more, because we each have a piece we fulfill. It's kind of like a giant puzzle, and one person told me once that we may not see it now, but each part we have is really significant, and where he's leading us, it can be scary, and it can be amazing, and that's what he's taught me with the international students, and they need us. There's conversation partners, which is at 3, we meet at 2:50 at the CCH, if you guys want to walk down with us, because going in that first time, it's hard, because you don't know what to expect, but it's a lot of fun, and there's definitely a need, because there's a very small group of us going right now, and there's a lot more international students. There's Green Tree class, which is at 7 o'clock on Tuesdays. And that's just like a different atmosphere. We like go over culture, and we just like build those relationships. And then there's Ralahos. If you want to give rides to international students, that's another option. Overall, I just encourage you just to build those relationships. If you had told me a year ago I would be doing the things I am now, I would not have believed you. Because taking that first step is often the hardest. And it's okay to be scared in that moment. But if you feel like God's calling you, then go ahead and do it. Because I guarantee you, it will change your life. And as another friend once reminded me, God is patient. He does not expect us to just jump full force, and he calls us to the small things first. That's what he did with me. But we also should remember that, as a quote once said, if God asks you to jump through a wall, it's our job to jump, and his job to move the wall. Which is kind of crazy to think about, but that's kind of what I feel like this calling has been in my life. But I don't regret it for the world, because it's helped me become who I am today, and international students are amazing. They're an amazing community, so I really encourage you to try and reach out to them. It'll definitely be worth it. I can promise you that. It may not always be easy, but it'll definitely be worth it. Thank you, guys.